There is a mysterious bug in Gmail going back at least 10 years that I've experienced many times, where emails that you had starred will occasionally seemingly go missing and not show up in the starred emails list. For example, here are two starred emails, but one of them does not show up in the starred list, nor does it show up if I use the is starred search filter or even the color specific has yellow star filter. It also doesn't even show the flagged status on the Apple Mail app, which corresponds to the starred status. But if anyone from Google is watching, I did finally find out the root cause, which I'll explain later, so it should be an easy fix, please. And for everyone watching, I also figured out a way to actually see if this happened to any of your emails, which I'll show later. Turns out I had over 75 emails with this problem across multiple Gmail accounts, some of them going back 13 years. Now, I've specifically noticed this problem happen only a handful of times, or so I thought, over the past like 10 years, and obviously it's concerning because if I star an email to remind myself about something important, it's a problem if it apparently doesn't show up in the starred list. What's worse is I couldn't even be sure how bad the problem was because I had no way of even searching for these bugged emails. You'd only see the starred status if you went to it directly or if it happened to show up in the results list because of some other filter you were doing. Otherwise, they'd just be buried deep in the inbox. There are several posts people have made about this problem over the years, but apparently no one ever fully figured out the problem until now. Just yesterday is when I had a big break and figured it out. You see, I have a list of links to emails that I've noticed do this over the years. I would just write it down, maybe eventually I'd figure it out. And while looking at it again, I figured that since the stars show up in the web interface, but seemingly nowhere else, maybe there was a clue in the code displaying the Gmail web interface. And I was right. There was a clue. After a lot of messing around in the Chrome developer panel, I eventually realized that the raw data with the info about the emails for the inbox page comes through in a network request that you could see if you refresh the page with the network tab open and filter for /FD, and then viewing the response tab. The same thing will work though if you load the page for a single email too. What I noticed is all emails will have a list of these properties of some kind, like smart label promo or SQIG personal, and this turned out to be the key. When I searched for one of these, one of the top results was a Google Doc called Google Secret System Labels, and this blew the case wide open. By going through my saved list of emails that had the problem, I gathered all the hidden labels for all of them to see if there was anything in common between them and how they might have differed from working star emails. And it turns out that the working starred emails would have two star-related tags. One is the T tag, which means starred, and is actually in an official list of these tags that Google mentions in a support article. The other is the SSSY tag, which apparently stands for superstar star yellow. Because, fun fact, if you didn't know, there's multiple possible star colors you can set. Importantly though, in addition to the regular T starred tag, all starred emails also get one corresponding to the color. Even the regular yellow star gets the SSY tag one. But I noticed that while all the broken emails had the superstar tag, they did not have the T tag. And this is the reason for their strange behavior. All the filters in Gmail go purely off the T tag to decide whether something is starred. And yes, I also know exactly what is causing this discrepancy with the tags. It is a bug, maybe even a second bug, that Google needs to fix. I'll go over that next. But now armed with this knowledge of the secret labels, I figured out you can actually search for the broken emails directly. Because fortunately, you can search for those hidden labels. You just need to be sure to put them in quotes for some reason. And then we also want to exclude any emails that are properly starred and would show up with this. Though you could also specify the hidden T label specifically, but this is the same thing apparently. I'll also put in the description a longer search filter that will include all the colors, so it should truly find all the broken starred emails. So basically we're searching for ones that have a color label but not the regular star label. And after doing this, I immediately realized that this happened more times than I thought. Across all my email accounts, I had about 75 of them going back as far as 2012. So basically, the reason these don't show up in the starred list or filter search or even as flagged emails in third-party apps is because those are all based on the hidden T label, which all the broken emails are missing. But the web interface apparently just goes off of the color label to display the star, which are still in those. But what would cause this to have only one of the two tags missing? I was wondering if it maybe had to do with the fact that I often use the Apple Mail app, including to flag and unflag emails, which also stars and unstars them in Gmail. Maybe there was a mismatch sometimes. And I was mostly right, but spoiler, it's not Apple's fault. I already mentioned how starring an email in the web interface adds both the regular and color-specific star labels behind the scenes, and unstarring it there removes both. So then I tested what happens if I star an email purely through Apple Mail. And while it does add the T label, it does not add the SSSY color label like the Gmail web interface does. But by the way, this does result in a fully properly working starred email. Apparently the web interface doesn't need a color label. But it made me think, wait a minute, if it only adds the T label, what if it only removes the T label as well? And sure enough, when I tested starring an email through the Gmail web interface and then unstarring it through Apple Mail, it resulted in an elusive broken star email. And while this is not the root cause, which I will explain next, after 10 years, I finally knew what sequence of actions was causing it and why I probably never noticed. But again, this is not Apple's fault. In a minute, I'll show how this is actually a bug with the Gmail API itself and affects all third-party Gmail apps. But now it explains why this bug is so rare, or at least when it happens, it's rarely noticed. I usually do handle my emails through my phone. And if I flag or star it from Apple Mail initially, then unflagging it will work fine, regardless of how, either from the app or web interface. It's only when I occasionally flag it on the web interface first, then unflag it through the app when it happens. And then, even still, I would rarely ever notice because I'm unflagging it for a reason. I'm done with that email and probably won't be looking for it again. So the only reason I would notice it is if I go looking for that specific email through the Gmail web interface or happen to do a search through the web interface where it shows up and I see the star there. But because I did occasionally see emails like that, maybe months or years down the line, and didn't know the cause, I assumed it was because Gmail was unstarring them erroneously, not remembering that I had unstarred it myself long ago. All I knew was that it's starred and doesn't show up in the starred list. So at least I now know that it's not that starred emails are going missing. It's kind of the opposite, actually. So when I found that out, I wasn't sure if the problem was with Apple Mail specifically, and I decided to do a test. In the Gmail API documentation, they conveniently have a tool on every page for the various commands where you can test them out. So I did a test on a random email of mine and used the messages.modify endpoint where you send a list of labels to add in the add label IDs field, and you can also remove labels with the remove label IDs field. To star or unstar an email, you have to put the value starred. And importantly, it seems you cannot put in a specific hidden label like T or SSSY, and you can probably see where this is going with that. Turns out that the official way to star and unstar via the Gmail API does not touch the color-specific labels behind the scenes in either case, only the basic T-starred labels. So if you both star, then unstar it with the API, it's not a problem. But if you starred it with the web interface, it won't remove the color label that got added. And like I said, this appears to be the proper and the only way to star an email through the API. So it's not the fault of third-party developers. Now that I knew this was an issue apparently with the API, I started Googling about the problem with API-related search terms, and it actually turns out other people did notice this before with the API, but it seems that no one ever realized it was because of those hidden tags. There's even an official Google bug tracker thread where Google acknowledged it as a bug and marked it as in progress way back in 2018, with no progress since. But nowhere in that thread or the Stack Overflow thread does anyone mention the hidden T label. Though there was this one guy who was so close to figuring it all out, recognizing that the reason it still appeared was because of the green specific label in his case, but didn't realize that the script technically was unstarring it partway because it removed the T label. After reading all this, I also realized why I hadn't found these API bug threads before and why no one made the connection when people like me were talking about our problem. It's because, funnily enough, from the perspective of those in the API bug threads, the problem was the opposite of mine. You see, for them, they were unable to unstar emails that they were trying to unstar. But for me and others, we didn't remember unstarring the emails. So when they mysteriously resurfaced and they didn't show up in the starred list, we thought that they had been unstarred against our will. But underneath it all, it's the same cause. And I would say there's actually two possible bugs at play here, sort of. The first is that obviously the API should be removing all star-related labels behind the scenes if someone unstars it, just like the web interface and native Gmail app do. Though, on the other hand, the simplest solution that would fix all the complaints is on the web interface side. If Google changed it so it no longer shows an email when there's only the color-specific label without the T label, that would visually fix everything. As a perfectionist, it would annoy me knowing that behind the scenes there's just a leftover color label, but by itself without the T label, it does nothing else now besides confuse people anyway. So they would have to fix that too, even if they fix the API side, because there are still remaining bugged emails. And I'll just point out that since all of the emails that would be affected by that change had already been unstarred by the user, they should not be showing a star at all anyway. So hiding the orphaned stars now would not be a problem. So at this point, with all this being laid out, I hope we can finally put this bug to rest. I actually think this has probably been around as long as Gmail itself. So if you happen to know anyone on the Gmail team, let them know. And I'll also put a link to the issue tracker thread in the description if you want to make sure that they're aware of this new development. I would also be very curious how many of you, after using the filter in the description, realize that you had some of these ghost-starred emails without knowing it. Let me know down in the comments how many you find. Or maybe you're like me and you noticed this many times but couldn't figure out why. In any case, if you enjoyed the video, of course, give it a big, giant, enormous, large thumbs up. It really helps out. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make a couple videos a week, so it should be worth it. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about a hidden good version of Google that you can set as your default search engine, but with a secret hidden parameter in the URL. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.